गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन।
गुड इवनिंग मैम।
गुड इवनिंग गाइस।
गुड इवनिंग। सो दिस इज एन इम्पोर्टेंट चैप्टर फॉर दोज हु आर ऑलरेडी इनसाइड द जॉब और मे बी कॉल्ड इज दैट हु आर द एंट्रेंस टू द जॉब। इट मीन्स व्हाट द यू नो द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ट्रेनिंग एंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डेवलपमेंट। यू द कैन आई आस्क टू द स्टूडेंट that what is the difference between training and development or both are the same? Is there any basic difference between training?
Yeah, hang on.
Okay, sorry from my side, there was some network error was arised. So for this purpose, the interruption has been done. The thing is that I was asking you that is there any difference between the training and development or both are the same? I am asking the questions to those students who are on the job. Any student who are on the job can say, is there any basic difference between training and development or both are the same? Yes? Any response from your side?
Aditya, yeah, ma'am.
Uh-huh.
So basically, ma'am, in my perspective, if we say like training is the short-term things or development is a long-term thing. Sometimes we have to involve in a various training activity, which is partly main or mainly focused on some customer-oriented courses or something that is particularly required for that specific project only. Apart from that, in long term, mainly development is considered as a long term or career oriented perspective, which is mainly considered as a long term achieve goal or the career path which leads to the more professional and personal growth as well.
Very good, Aditya. Once again, I'm congratulating you. The thing is that training is only giving only to the persons that are in the lower cadre, and education is the is a process which can be given to the higher cadre persons. Training is just like that is a thing that can be given to any person that maybe is called as an entrance towards a job, while development can be given to a professional or expertise to a job. Training is a short-term process and development is a long-term process. But if a person having no training before entering in any type of the job, then a person cannot be developed. Through the training, a person has developed. So there are many differences are there. We will cover after that what are the basic differences between training and development. But now in this class, I am going to discuss about the methods of training, what is training, what are the inputs of training, what are the types of the methods of the training, what is the basic difference between training and development, and what is the need and process of the training. So these for the exam purposes, the 4 and 5 points that are coming in your examinations, these all things are there. First is that what do you mean by the training? Training means what? The training refers to the imparting of some specific skill, ability and knowledge to an employee. So if an employee is entering in a training or attending a training, then he will get some specific skill, specific ability, specific knowledge relating to the job that he is going to undergo. जो job को वो join करना चाहता है उस job के related में जो चीज मिलता है वो training के माध्यम से मिलता है. So training means what? It refers to, it is called as a process. It may be called as a process through which a person can get some specific skill, some specific ability, some specific knowledge relating to the job that he is going to continue. Okay, in future he is going to continue. So training, why there is that? Now the questions come that if a person is eligible, because in human resource management what happened, we are having the recruitment process, then after the selection process, the person is placed. After the person was placed, then there is a orientation process. After the orientation process, the training comes. Before the training, the orientation comes, and after the orientation, the training will come. So if a person is eligible for a particular type of the job, then why there is a need of the training? Because we know that for a can anyone be said that, Aditya, I am asking you again, that if you are shortlisted for a job or if you are selected for a job like that of a typist type of job, like that a computer type of the job, computer your specialist type of the job, so do you think that you require again a training? Do you think so?
Not, but if sometimes it needed to be like some specific task to be done for the specific project, then we have to enhance our skill. But that is, the duration is short term, like 1 week or 10 days like that.
Okay, Aditya, very good. The thing is that whatever may be the job, whatever may be the person, whatever may be the selection, but the training is the need and the training is the requirement of every person. Okay, you may know the job or you may not know the nature of the job, but basically you should go through the process of the training. Because the need of, why there is the need of the training? Because it says that through the training, the need of the training can be evaluated by the two things. One is called as the standard performance minus the actual performance. Standard performance minus actual performance means what? Suppose you are attending a job, suppose you are joining a job, in the first day of your job, your company manager told you that your standard performance is this and your actual performance is this, and there is a huge gap in between your actual performance and the standard performance, and in order to cover the gap or in order to cover the lag, there is a requirement of the training. So in every circumstances, the training is necessary. Okay, is there in a teaching profession, is there any type of your clerical profession, whatever may be, sometimes understudy training is required, sometimes supervisor training is required, sometimes the long process or long process sometimes may be called as a sensitive training is required. Sometimes the many types of the training are required depending upon the nature of the job and depending upon the nature of your knowledge. How much you know, how much you have your knowledge relating to your job, so depending upon your knowledge you are selected for how, which type of the training that you are going to undergo. कौन सा ट्रेनिंग के माध्यम से और कौन सी ट्रेनिंग आपको ज्वाइन करना है उसके माध्यम से आपको खुद को सिलेक्ट करना पड़ता है. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द नीड्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग एंड दिस इज ऑल अबाउट योर द मीनिंग ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग. नाउ कम्स अबाउट दैट डायरेक्टली कम्स अबाउट द डिफरेंट योर मीनिंग ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग. आई थिंक दैट इट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू यू टू डिस्क्राइब अबाउट व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग बिकॉज यू नो द ट्रेनिंग इज द एक्ट ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग द नॉलेज ऑफ स्किल ऑफ एन एम्प्लॉई फॉर डूइंग ए पर्टिकुलर जॉब बिसाइड्स एन पर्सन्स हैविंग सम एक्सपर्टाइज ऑफ द नॉलेज बट थ्रू द ट्रेनिंग ए पर्सन्स कॉन्फिडेंस ए पर्सन्स नॉलेज ए पर्सन स्किल्स ए पर्सन्स एबिलिटी वॉज इंक्रीज्ड. ओके बिसाइड्स ए पर्सन मे बी हैविंग ए सच टाइप ऑफ स्पेशलाइज्ड इन द एक्सपर्ट in the knowledge but if you are entering a type of a training like that of called is a training like that of sensitivity training, in that part of the training what happened a type of what the artificial situation has been created by which the ability, the knowledge, the skill of an employee was increased. So this is the different type of the training method that was introduced in before of a customer or before of a participant in order relating to the expertise of his knowledge relating to his ability that who is part of the training that should be given to the customer, to the persons. So there are different definition of the training that you must go through this the definition like that of training is the organized procedure by which the people learn knowledge and skill for a definite process. Okay, the trainer will acquire new manipulative skills, technical knowledge, problem solving. So this is not training, this is called as development, because through the development a persons can acquire the manipulative skill that is called as what, the interpersonal skill. So manipulative skill, technical knowledge, problem solving ability and or attitudes. So here 4 points are there, like manipulative skill that is called as interpersonal skill, technical knowledge that is coming under the training process, problem solving ability that comes under the development process, and of and or attitude that also coming under the development. So there is a combinations of the what the points of both the training and the development in this paragraph. That paragraph 3, the training will acquire new manipulative skill, technical knowledge, problem solving ability or attitudes. Training is not one step process, but it is a continuous or ever ending process. Yes, the training makes newly recruited workers fully productive in the minimum of time. Even for old worker, training is necessary to refresh them and to conservative with the required. It means that whether you are a new entrance into a job, whether you are already inside that job or existing, or whether maybe you may be experienced one, you must require what? The training and the development for updating your knowledge, for acquiring new and new skills, for updating your the technical knowledge, for professional knowledge, for everything. The training is the main theme or the main aspect. Now come about that, what is the difference between training, development and education? What I asked to Aditya, that what is the basic difference between the training, development and education? So in a nutshell, there is nothing but training. There is the training means what? It is a non-managerial personnel. Development is for managerial person. Training means what do you mean by training here? The technical and mechanical operations means how to operate. Okay. Technical and mechanical operation means you through the training you know about the process of how to operate some things. Through the development you may be gained some theoretical or maybe some academic knowledge, concept or may you are comprehending with many ideas. Through training, specific job related purposes, it means if you are in a type of fitter type of job and your training should be related with that type of the job. But in the development process, you should be expertise in the general knowledge. The training is for a short term period and the development is for a long term period. So this is the basic difference between the training and the development. For whom the training was given, inside the training what was given, why the training is required and when the training is there. It means what is the period, short terms, long term, why the training has been given. The training has been given in order to expertise a person with a job that is related with his specific job. It means that the job that he is going to attend. It is only in the development process, through the development, a person's general knowledge can be increased. Second, inside the training, what training? Training means is nothing. It is called as a technical and mechanical operation. What the development is thing? The development means the theoretical concepts or theoretical ideas, some comprehending ideas, some comprehending concepts. So this is called as the training. So development. So this is the basic difference between training and the development. Now come about, again, there is a lengthy process of difference between the training and the development. I think it's not required to repeat this, so just skip. Now come about what is the importance of training. So this is the most important one. What are the importance of training? In the importance of training, you must know that the first thing is that training helps to to remove the performance deficiency. Training helps to remove the performance deficiency in employee. Suppose an employee is in a job, his performance is not so good and not expected good. And at that time, what happened if he is entering in a training or attending a training, then what will happen? Then the performance of an employee can be at a good level. It means what? It helps to remove the performance deficiency in employee. What you are expecting from the persons, if there is any type of deficiency from the desired person, desired persons, then through the training process, a person's performance can be increased. So it can be called as the training helps to improve the performance deficiency in persons. The second one is what? This is the I am telling you about the importance of the training. Just write down. 1111 point. Okay, so there are I will repeat, there are 5 to 6 points of training. Just write down in your notebook with your pen. Okay, so first thing is that the training helps to remove the performance deficiency in employee. Performance deficiency employee means what? Every person has certain type of deficiency while performing a job. If a person is attending a training, through the training process, it may remove all the obstacles of deficiency इन एम्प्लॉय परफॉर्मेंस. आपका कोई प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है जॉब में, सपोज मुझे कंप्यूटर नहीं आता है, तो थ्रू द ट्रेनिंग प्रोसेस में क्या करता हूँ, तो कंप्यूटर का मुझे थोड़ा सा नॉलेज हुआ, तो उसमें क्या हुआ, मेरे परफॉर्मेंस डेफिशिएंसी गायब हो गया. ओके, आपको आप कोई जॉब में हो तो उसमें आपको क्या नहीं आता है, सपोज आपको पता नहीं है कि कैसे किस प्रोसेस में आपको पढ़ाना है, सपोज आपको रिसर्च के बारे में पता नहीं होता है. सो थ्रू दैट आपके डेवलपमेंट प्रोसेस में, जैसे आपका FDP हुआ, फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम, सो इस बेसिस में आपको पता है कि कैसे एरिया में आपको रिसर्च पेपर लिखना है, जर्नल लिखना है, आपका थीसिस और जर्नल के बीच में डिफरेंस क्या है. ये क्या होता है, ये सिर्फ डेवलपमेंट प्रोसेस के माध्यम से ये चीज होता है. सो दिस इज called as what? That through the training, that it may be removes all the deficiency, all the obstacles, all the problems in employees' performance. Students, आपको मेरा sound, मेरा जो आवाज का clarity आ रहा है या नहीं आ रहा है, कोई problem तो नहीं है? कोई problem है? बताओ.
No, ma'am.
आप सारा लिख रहे हो ना, नहीं लिख रहे हो?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The second thing is that the training increase ability and motivations among the people. Again, this was repeating here. So training increase what? The ability of a person. What ability? What your expertise? Initially, what was your expertise? What was your ability? But after getting the training, a person's expertise and a person's ability is naturally increased. Then it also motivate a person to do more and more productive work for the organizations. Because through the training, what happened? The skill of an employee has been increased. So there may be no wastages was there. There may be no errors was there. So through this process, the motivations of the employee was increased. Just like I am telling you that whenever you are a new entrance in a college or maybe in any type of the school, sometimes what happened in the first class or maybe in your first day, what happened, there may be some frustrations, there may be some nervousness from your side. But if you are undergo through the training process, like that of the sensitivity training was created before you are entering inside your classroom or maybe the school, then what will happen? You know how to address the student, how to address your colleagues, colleagues, how to make the positive relationship with the superior boss. So this type of the things or this type of the ability that initially you have improved. So by this process, what happened? That it increases the ability through the training, it increases the ability and also motivations among the peoples. The third point is that it increases the potentiality of the employee, which helps to contribute the growth of the organization. Again, if you are motivated to do the work through the training process, then what will happen? It increases the what the growth of the organization, that it increase or it motivates the potential customer to do more and more productive work towards the organizations. So it's in the third point you can write that it increases the potentiality of the employee, which helps to contribute the growth of the organizations. Potentiality of the employee means what? The positive behavior of the employee. It increases the positive, the motivated employee. It increases the positive behavior of the employee towards the organizations to do more and more productive work, by which what happened? The growth of the organizations has been in a what? In a targeted stage. It may be called as in a directly in a higher stages. The fourth point is that the training make the employee versatile in operations. Versatile means what? You are a person master in all arts, master in all things. That is called as that having a versatile character. So through the training process, a person's having knowledge about many skill, about many things that what he is what he wants to desire. Through the training process, for what will happen after you are getting, after you are attending the training process, sometimes what happen, you if there is some vacant in some job or in some post, then you in the absence of that person, then you can also do that thing or do that your function inside the organizations. Take one example is here, I am telling you, like that of a person is in a marketing capacity. So in marketing capacity, a person should have a knowledge about how to sell, how to purchase, how, where to purchase, whom to purchase, how to invest, how to increase the profit. So these things that you can get what through the training process. Okay, just like what do you mean by what is the meaning of your door-to-door your selling process, how a person can increase a product from 25% to 35%. So in the inside the company, what happened, if you are already having you are already a master of a versatile character, then what will happen if in your absence of your boss, sometimes your boss is absent, then at that period what will happen, for 10 to 20 days you can also run the organizations. So it may be called as that the training make the employee the versatile in his operations. Operations means that any person who are undergo with the training, that he can do any type of the job that was entrusted on them. Usko jo bhi kaam milega wo aaram se wo kaam ko kar sakta hai. Then the next one is called is that the accidents, ye sara cheez main apne man se bol rahi hu, point aap likhte chalo, iske baad main aapko ignore se chalungi. ओके सो फिफ्थ पॉइंट आपका ये होता है, सपोज एक्सीडेंट हुआ, आपका स्क्रैप हुआ, आपका डैमेज हुआ, ऐसे कौन आदमी करता है आप बताओ? आपको कोई चीज का आपको पैकिंग करना है, अगर आपका कोई चीज का प्रोडक्शन में जा रहा है, प्रोसेसिंग में हो रहा है, तो इसमें क्या होता है, मैक्सिमम नंबर्स ऑफ एक्सीडेंट होता है, मैक्सिमम नंबर्स आपका स्क्रैप होता है, मैक्सिमम नंबर्स आपका डैमेज होता है. तो इसको अवॉइड कैसे करें आप बताओ? आप बताओ धरश्री, आप बताओ, कंपनी में आपकी कंपनी में जॉब करते हो, सपोज आप किसी जॉब में हो क्या धरश्री?
नो मैम.
ओके, एनी अदर पर्सन? अच्छा धरश्री, कोई बात नहीं, आप जॉब में नहीं हो तो भी मैं आपको पूछ रही हूँ. सपोज आप एक कंपनी में हो, ठीक है ना? सपोज मैं बता रही हूँ, आप एक बिस्किट के दुकान कंपनी में बैठे हो, एक बिस्किट जो आपका होता है कौन सा, गुड्डे वाला हुआ या एम्ब्रो हुआ, या कोई भी बिस्किट की दुकान में शॉप में आप एक क्या मार्केटिंग नहीं तो आप सेल्स मैनेजर हो. ओके सॉरी, प्रोडक्शन मैनेजर हो. सो प्रोडक्शन मैनेजर क्या काम है आपको, क्या क्या काम है? जब आप कोई चीज का प्रोड्यूस होता है, बिस्किट का जो प्रोडक्शन होता है, तो उसको आप क्या करते हो, ऑब्जर्वेशन करते हो. आप उसी टाइम क्या होता है, आप देखते हो ज्यादा से ज्यादा उसमें एक्सीडेंट होता है, आपका स्क्रैप होता है प्रोडक्ट का, ज्यादा से ज्यादा आपकी डैमेज होता है, तो आप क्या करोगे बताओ?
मैम आई विल प्रोवाइड द ट्रेनिंग, प्रॉपर ट्रेनिंग टू द एम्प्लॉइज, सो दैट दे कैन how to manage the products in a well manner.
Okay, so all the persons that who are already indulged in your company or in your offices, they are already trained. they are already trained. But the thing is that after that period, again, there may be some accident, there's some scrapping, some type of damages are happened, okay, relating to your emotions, relating to your product. So how can you ever? Are you want to make the job your labor turnover? आप लेबर को चेंज कर दोगे क्या? आप बताओ, कोई और?
नो मैम.
तो क्या कर सकते हैं आप बताओ?
मैम, जो एम्प्लॉय अभी प्रेजेंट है कंपनी में, उनको बेटर टेक्निकल स्किल्स, मतलब कैसे एक्सीडेंट्स को हम अवॉइड कर सकते हैं, उसके लिए बेटर ट्रेनिंग प्रोवाइड कर सकते हैं.
या द थिंग इज दैट that for a production manager, that he or she has to identify the persons persons who are always meeting that type of the accident, the scrapping, that type of the damage relating to the machines or relating to the product. That person has to identify that type of the employees inside in the ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट आर वर्किंग. ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के अंदर जो जो काम कर रहे, पहले आप उस लोगों को आपको आइडेंटिफाई करना है और उनको प्रॉपर मेथड पे ट्रेनिंग में भेजना है. मतलब कौन सी मेथड उनके लिए आप, क्योंकि ट्रेनिंग एक टाइप की नहीं होता है, बहुत सारे प्रकार के ट्रेनिंग होता है, तो इनके लिए कौन सी ट्रेनिंग सुइटेबल है उसको देख के आपको सेंड करना है. ओके, इफ यू आर गेटिंग प्रॉपरली द ट्रेनिंग प्रोसेस, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, देन यू कैन अवॉइड द एक्सीडेंट, यू कैन ऑल्सो अवॉइड द स्क्रैप, you can also avoid the damage to the machinery, to the product, and it can be easily minimized. आपका कभी भी problem नहीं हो सकता, धीरे 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 ये क्या है, आपका कम होना शुरू हो जाएगा. Then the next one is called as that. So in the fifth point, you have to write, through the training, the accident can be minimized, the scrap and the damage can also be reduced and can be avoided. The accident can be avoided and the scrap can be reduced. Okay, only through the training process, if the proper training has been given, then the three particular things can be reduced, can be minimized, or can be avoided. Clear, student? Then the next one is that the dissatisfactions, complaint, absenteeism, and labor turnover can be reduced. Do you think so? Dissatisfactions, complaint, absenteeism, and labor turnover can be reduced through the training process. Do you think so? ये ठीक लग रहा है आपको? आपको अगर ट्रेनिंग दिया जाएगा तो आपका डिससैटिस्फेक्शन कम हो जाएगा, कॉम्प्लेन कम हो जाएगा, एब्सेंटिज्म कम हो जाएगा, एंड लेबर टर्नओवर इन बी रिड्यूस्ड आल्सो. डू यू थिंक सो? एनी अदर स्टूडेंट? डिससैटिस्फेक्शन, व्हाई यू आर डिससैटिस्फाइड इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, व्हाइल यू आर वर्किंग ऑन योर जॉब, you every time you have your satisfaction or you don't have any type of satisfaction on it? Why there is the increase of dissatisfaction? Any other student jo job mein ho aap bata sakte ho? Try to say. No other? Try to say. Aditya, आदित्य, हेलो आदित्य, नंदा, ओके, गायत्री स्वाई, नो रेस्पॉन्स, ओके. आई थिंक दैट यू आर ऑन द जॉब एंड यू डोंट नो दैट व्हाई देर इज ए इंक्रीजिंग ऑफ डिससैटिस्फेक्शन. यू नो, डोंट नो. इफ यू डोंट नो अबाउट दैट हाउ टू अकॉम्प्लिश ए जॉब, if you are a job and if you don't know about how to accomplish a job, it means that you don't have possessing any knowledge about the process of completing a job, then what will happen? There is a creating of dissatisfaction, increasing of dissatisfaction in there. The second thing is that the complaint also, that if you are not a trained person, then someone will file a complaint against you. Okay, so this comes under the complaint. Then the third one is called as the absenteeism. Absenteeism means what? अगर आप ट्रेन नहीं हो तो आप क्या है, आप क्लास में आने के लिए, आपको कंपनी में आने के लिए आपको डर लगता है, तो उसमें क्या होता है, यू आर इंक्रीजिंग द absenteeism इनसाइड द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. Then last one is called as the labor turnover. Labor turnover means what? If a person is not trained, then what will happen? Gradually, sometimes the laborers, they will left the job, otherwise the manager will remove the person from the job. Because you have no knowledge, you have no confidence, you have no ability, then what happened? Simultaneously, gradually one day will come, the laborer will be. So there will be the labor turnover. The manager will leave you. The manager will insist you to resign from the job. Or maybe sometimes what happened due to the dissatisfaction, you will resign the job. So these are the four factors of the importance of the training. Then next one is called as the through the training, it improves what? The job knowledge. So if you are a new person in a job, then after getting the job, you have improved what? The job knowledge relating to the job. So these are called as the importance of the training. So there are many importance of the training. So in the nutshell, I am telling you that these are the importance of the training. So you can also write through the follow-up of selection procedure, better performance, reduction in the cost production, reduce supervisions. So if you are trained a person, there is no need of any type of supervision. So all times what happened? If you are not expertise in your job, so you always needed a person who will be who is a supervisor or who is the expert in your job. आपको कोई काम नहीं आता है, आप कंपनी में ज्वाइन कर लिया, तो उस टाइम क्या होता है, आप एक सुपरवाइजर को चाहते हो कि मुझे आपके वो ऑन द जॉब आप ट्रेन करेगा कि ये करना है आपको, इधर ये मशीन को रखना है. सो इट ऑल्सो रिड्यूस द सुपर बिकॉज यू आर अ ट्रेन, इफ यू आर ऑलरेडी अ ट्रेन पर्सन देन यू नीड नॉट रिक्वायर एनी टाइप ऑफ सुपरवाइजर. देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड एज इंक्रीज्ड द मोरल थ्रू द ट्रेनिंग. व्हाट हैपेंड, द मोरल ऑफ द एम्प्लॉई कैन बी बूस्टेड, इट कैन बी इंक्रीज द मोरल ऑफ द एम्प्लॉई इफ देयर गिवन proper training as a common objective of the organizations. If it's a common objective of the organization, training program molds its employee attitudes to achieve supports for the organization activity and obtain better cooperation and greater loyalty. With the help of tiny dissatisfactions, complaint, absenteeism and turnover can also be reduced among the executive. Thus, training helps in building an efficient and cooperative workforce. Yes, increased moral means what? The morality of an individual was increased through the process. So this all about what? The need of the training or the major advantages of the training process. Then advantages to the executive. What is the advantage of the executive? So you know that the executive, the personal persons or maybe the lower category persons, they require the training. Through the training, it gives or it boosts it will give the help to the executive. So these are the following the advantages of the executive. The first one is called increase in wage earning capacity. Job security was there and chances of the promotion is there. Okay, so three things are happening through the training process, because training helps the executive in acquiring the new knowledge and job skill. In this way, it increases their market value, wage earning power, leading in increase in the payment. Job security is there because you know about that how to, when to, and by whom to you have to perform the job, by which whatever no one is there who will insisting you to resign the job, who will insisting you that you will be fired on one day. So this cannot be happen in your lifetime period. Then chances of promotion is very bright, because through the training, you are excellent in your job through the training process, and you will be through the training, it will boost the knowledge of an individual and he can do the work or he can increase the productivity of the organization with a very short span of the time, and by which what happened, your boss will happy on you and he will give you promotion. So there is a more chances of promotions in the training process. Student, any doubt? Advantages to the executive. मैं ही बोल रही हूँ, आप कोई बोलते नहीं हो, बताओ कोई डाउट है?
No ma'am.
समझ में आ रहा है?
Yes ma'am, आ रहा है समझ में.
अच्छा, स्पीड तो नहीं हो रहा है धरश्री?
No ma'am, ठीक है.
ठीक है ना? जो मैं पॉइंट बोल रही हूँ आप लिखते चलो, फिर इसमें जो आपका जो सिला मतलब आपके जो है ना कॉन्सेप्ट है ना, उसको थोड़ा थोड़ा निकाल के छोटे छोटे दो तीन लाइन में लिखते चलो, ठीक है? देन व्हाट आर द लिमिटेशन ऑफ टाइम बिसाइड सेविंग्स, बिकॉज एवरीथिंग सेविंग द टू थिंग्स, द प्रोस एंड द कॉइंस, दो ऑल्दो देयर इज सम मे बी सम एडवांटेजेस, देयर इज आल्सो सम डिसएडवांटेजेस और मे बी सम लिमिटेशंस आर देयर. So, first thing is that the training is costly affair and expensive process, making organizations to spend substantial amount taken out of other organizational commitment. Yes, because you know that a person who was selected through the eligibility criteria, through the ability, through the knowledge, through the expertise, but instead of possessing everything, that he has to undergo through the training period for maybe a period of 6 months or maybe 1 month or 2 months, and it was the total cost was incurred by the organization. So it may be as a costly affairs. So why there is a need of the training? If a person is expertise in every field, a person is eligible for his job, then why there is the need of what? The training. So this means what? As the training process was totally what the as the training process was totally processed by the organization, so it is totally a costly affairs. Then the second one is that the training may result in dislocations of work and loss of output because regular office work is likely to be interrupted or delayed because of the time of training spent in time training. Yes, because after attending a job for after 1 month or maybe for 1.5 months, a person is directed to undergo for the process of the training. So it is very problem for an organizations that how to complete the job to of a person that person the person seat was vacant. जो person गया है उस vacant seat को काम कौन करेगा? तो उसके लिए भी organizations के अंदर भी problem शुरू होता है. So by which what happened? The regular officials work was interrupted. It will take a very lengthy the time in order to cover the work by the officers whenever the officers have joined the job. And the third thing is that there is due to the dislocations of the office of the officers from the main office to the training your center, by the which what happened sometimes what the motivation of an employee has been decreased also, because after returning from the your training center that the persons have no have no has not that much of your motivation at the time was time of their appointment. तो appointment के time में जो उसका motivation होता था, जब वो training करके return करके आता है, तो वो motivation नहीं रहता है, तो उसमें उसका problem होना शुरू हो जाता है. Sometimes it is difficult to obtain good training instructor. Yes, it is not important, but you can also include here. Then self-reliance and capacity for new ideas might be stifled. Okay, it is also not there. You have to write down 1 and 2 points only. That is a costly affair. And second one is that what the interruption of the regular official work of the person who is undergo for a period of the training. जो लोग training के लिए गए हैं, उनका जो काम करने के लिए problem हो जाता है, तो ये होता है एक lengthy process. तो ये दोनों limitations of training में लिख देना है. Then the next one is called as the assessment of the training needs. Okay, so how you can assessing the training needs? The training needs are identified on the basis of organizational analysis, job analysis, manpower analysis. The training program, training methods, and course contents have to be planned in keeping with the training needs. The training needs are those aspects necessary to perform the job in an organization in which the executive is lacking attitudes, aptitudes, knowledge, and skills. Okay, so the following are the methods are used to assess the training needs. Okay, so what are the things that you have to assess during the time of the training? Okay, so what the because you know that every person has undergone the period of the training, so during the training process, what are the different things that you have to assess? Okay, what are the different things? The first thing is that if you are introducing a training period or the training method, then first of all you have to noting down that what is the organizational requirement and what is the weakness. Okay, what is there is the is there is any type of increase of your accident, wastage, loss, or maybe called as the your what there may be the decreasing of ability of a person, poor performance. So whatever may be the good point and what are the different type of bad point, that you have to noted it down, and through the process that you have to find out what type of training should be given to an employee. Then second one is that departmental requirement and weakness. The same thing, the first one is general requirement and second one is the departmental requirement. Then the third one is called as the job specification and employee specifications. What the job is actually required and what the employee has actually possessed. Okay. What the job is actually required and what the employee actually possessed. That's point number three. Number four, identifying the specific problems. What the job is, if you are identifying the gap in between the job requirement and the employee specification, then you can easily identify the specific problems. Then the third one is that anticipating future problem. If the employee is undergoing with the same speed, with the same performance, then there may be sometimes a future problems will be arise. So you have to anticipating and you have to expecting whether the if it will be processed in the same manner, then there will be heavy loss or maybe maybe some small loss is there. If you are anticipating heavy loss, then what will happen? You will be immediately switched up to the training. So it is called as the anticipating the future problems. Then the management's request. You have to requesting the manager that suddenly we have to introduce a training program. Then the observations, interview, group conference, questionnaire survey, test of examinations, checklist, and performance appraisal. So everything are there before you have to you make some interview from other persons that actually you need the training. Sometimes before the interview you are observing a person's grade continuously, then some group conferences, group discussion, through every process the methods are used, these methods are used to assessing the training needs. Okay, so these are the 13 methods that through the 13 methods you are assessing the training needs. Now come to the next point, that is called as the learning and teachings. Okay, so learning and teachings, I will repeating last in my class this chapter. Again you come to here, okay, directly to the method of training. Okay, so this is the most important for your examinations point of view. What do you mean by the your training methods? Okay, so we all know that there are two types of method. Okay, the two types of methods of training is there. One is called as that your on the job training method, and second one is called as the off the job training method. Okay, so there are two types of methods of training. The one is called as that on the job training, and second one is called as that the off the job training. So the basic difference between the on the job training and the off the job training is that while you are on the job, that is called as the on the job training, and while you are off the job, it is called as that the off the job training. So it means what? In the on-the-job person, the person is taking the training by doing, and in the off-the-job person, and in the off-the-job method, the person is getting something by learning. Okay, so it is called as what? There are two basic difference between the on-the-job training and this and the off-the-job training. Okay, जब आप job में रह के कोई training करते हो, job के ऊपर आप training करते हो, तो उसको होता है on-the-job training, and the next is called as that the off-the-job training. So here in the on the job training, what will happen while you are on the job? So take one example, who is that some supervisor you're giving you training while you are on the duty. So this is coming under the on the job training. But if you for a specific period of the time you left the job and you attend some training process, so sometimes it is called as that the training by doing is called as on the job training, and training by learning it is called as off the job. This is the basic thing you have to note it down, the thing, the training by doing is called as on the job, the training by learning is called as off the job. Okay. So in this here, what will happen? The worker by this method learn to master the operations involved on the actual job situations under the supervision of his immediate boss who undertake the responsibility. So this thing is that while you are on the job, so you are trained by doing something. Okay. So you are on the job, training by doing is called as on the job. So the common, the most common form of on-the-job training program is training for a specific job. Current practice in training was first designed to improve the job performance through job instruction. On-the-job training conducted through these things. The first one is called as the experience. Okay, so what do you mean by the experience here? This is the oldest method of on-the-job training method, but as an exclusive approaches, it is wasteful, time-consuming, inefficient. It has been observed that it should be followed by other training method to make it more effective. On the job problem solving and colleagues interactions were promoted as most important for professional growth. So it means what? Through the experience of some your old colleague, okay, by the older experience of some old colleagues, that you can easily solve your problems. So it is called as the on-the-job training. Take one example is here that there may be some huge loss in the selling of the marketing product. So at that time, what happened? The marketer or maybe the production, your seller, or you may be called as that your marketing agent, he can be directly approached to the person who was having an experience of 20 to 30 years of in that period, that these are my problems, that how could I solve these problems. So while he was on the job, so he can ask. Sometimes it may be effective or sometimes may be ineffective, but by this problem what happened, it is cost consuming because there is no need to go anywhere. You are just asked the person by making a call, telephonic call to that person, that I was facing this type of problems and how could I come out by give some problem solving methods. So this is coming under the experience. Okay. Then the next one is called as that the coaching. So you all know about the coaching. What do you mean by coaching? Just like is the tuitions is nothing is the coaching. So on the job coaching by a supervisor is an important and potential effective approach. If supervisor is properly trained and oriented, the supervisor provides feedback to the trainee on his performance and offers him some suggestions for improvement. Upon the trainee share his thoughts, views, apprehensions about the duty and responsibility with the boss and thus get relief and relieves him of his burden. A limitation of this method of training is that the trainee may not have the freedom of opportunity to express his own idea because the trainer happens to his immediate boss. So in that cases, what happened? Just like your tuition and coaching. Okay, there are a number of coaching institute like that of tuitions are there. So here what happened, the person should be expertise on that specific field. Okay, when you are your coach, sometime take one example, your football coach, your volleyball coach, sometimes your tuition master. So these are called as that the coaching type of the person who was giving you coaching, that he is called as a coach. So in many circumstances what happened, the trainee are not free, they're not having that much of the freedom to express his own idea or in his own problems in front of your coach. Okay, so by this purpose, what happened? It totally depends upon what the attitudes of the coach, that whether the coach is the coach is a friendly person, whether the coach having that giving that much of the freedom to the trainee to express his view or to express his idea. So sometimes it totally depends upon the environment or the circumstances where the trainee has been given. जिस जो सर्कमस्टेंसेस के अंदर ट्रेनिंग दिया जाता है तो उस सर्कमस्टेंसेस को नजर में रखते ये बोला जाता है कि एक्चुअली ये आपका पॉजिटिव में जाएगा और अपॉर्चुनिटी क्रिएट करेगा या नहीं करेगा. सो इट टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन व्हाट द टाइप ऑफ रिलेशंस इन बिटवीन द ट्रेनर एंड द ट्रेनिंग. If the type of relation is of the trainer and the trainee is good, then is a friendly, then what will happen? A person can be easily what? Learn many things from the trainer. Okay, so this is called as the coaching. The coaching means what? The coacher should be his superior boss. Superior boss means what? The person that he know the person, he did his duty under the supervision of person, he may be called as a coacher. Then the next one is called as a understudy. So this is the most important thing in a company. What do you mean by the understudy? The understudy method is considered a somewhat different approaches from those described above. That if a certain person is specifically designated as the heir apparent, the understudy method makes the trainee an assistance to the current job holder. The trainee learn by experience, observations and limitations of the style of person he asked to work with. The trainee is informed about the policies, method, techniques, etc. The advantages of this method is that the training is conducted in a practical and realistic situation. Nothing else. Understudy ka matlab hota hai, ek aadmi kuch din ke liye deputations mein gaya hai, us job ke liye aap kuch din kar rahe ho. ठीक है, ऑन द स्पॉट यू आर एंगेजिंग और यू आर प्लेस्ड ऑन द इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ दैट एम्प्लॉई. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द अंडरस्टडी. सो अंडरस्टडी इज नथिंग बट यू आर अपॉइंटेड ऑन दैट पोस्ट फॉर ए टेम्पररी पीरियड ऑफ द टाइम. ओके, बाय विच यू कैन लर्न द मिस्टेक्स एंड यू कैन लर्न अबाउट व्हाट द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द पोस्ट. Okay, so this is called as the understudy. So understudy method is what? By attending the job, the person having, sometimes the persons can increase his knowledge or increase the ability, and sometimes not. So it may be said that understudy method makes the trainee an assistant to the current job holder. The trainee learn by experience, by observations, by imitations of the style of the person he asked to work with. The trainee is informed about the policy. इट मीन्स वो जॉब पे नहीं है, आपको इन्फॉर्म किया जाता है कि यही आपको करना है. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अंडरस्टडी. इट मीन्स दैट यू आर इन द टाइप ऑफ द जॉब दैट यू हैव जॉइंड फॉर ए टेम्पररी पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. स्टूडेंट आई एम आस्किंग यू, आई एम टेकिंग सम पॉज, आई एम आस्किंग यू दैट इन बिटवीन द थ्री पॉइंट्स एक्सपीरियंस कोचिंग अंडरस्टडी डू यू हैव एनी डाउट. हैविंग एनी डाउट देन आस्क. Any doubt? What is the basic difference between experience and coaching? No answer? Are you all there or not?
Ma'am. Ma'am, in experience, हम लोग मतलब जो हमसे ज्यादा एक्सपीरियंस है, मतलब एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में क्या कि एक फील्ड में अगर कोई 10 साल 15 साल से काम कर रहा है, अगर हम लोग नए ज्वाइन किए हैं उस फील्ड में, तो हम उससे आइडियाज ले सकते हैं, मतलब कैसे इस पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन से हम डील कर सकते हैं. उसके लिए
एनी पर्सन हु कैन बी द आउटसाइडर बट हु कैन हु हैव बीइंग एक्सपर्टाइज ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर फील्ड.
Yes,
is possessing expertise knowledge on that particular field. But in contrary with this experience, coaching means what? The person should be inside the company and he possessing the expertise on that particular. वो आपको पहचानता है coaching वाला, लेकिन experience वाला जो होता है आपको पहचानो या नहीं पहचानो उसमें कोई उसका ये नहीं है, आपको directly वो guide कर सकता है. So this is the basic difference between experience and coaching. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. और कोई पूछना है किसी को या मैं आगे जाऊं? गायत्री स्वाई कौन है जो आप कभी पूछते नहीं हो? गायत्री स्वाई, संबित सिंह, क्या हुआ आपको? हाँ पूछो गायत्री. हेलो गायत्री, पूछो.
यस मैम.
पूछो पूछो, क्या डाउट है?
नो मैम.
सब समझ में आ गया?
मैं थोड़ा सा लेट में ज्वाइन करी.
अच्छा कोई बात नहीं. ट्रेनिंग कितनी, ट्रेनिंग का मेथड कितने टाइप्स के होते हैं बताओ गायत्री?
कोचिंग एंड
बताओ. नहीं 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 नहीं, और कौन बोलेगा? ट्रेनिंग, हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग्स आर देयर जनरली, ब्रॉडली हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग्स आर देयर, मेथड्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग?
मैम टू टाइप्स, ऑन द जॉब ट्रेनिंग एंड ऑफ द जॉब ट्रेनिंग.
Okay, the meaning of on the job and off the job is?
ऑन द जॉब मीन्स बाय जॉय बाय डूइंग एंड
लर्निंग
ऑफ द
बाय
जॉब
डूइंग,
मीन्स ट्रेनिंग बाय लर्निंग.
वेरी गुड. ट्रेनिंग बाय लर्निंग एंड ट्रेनिंग बाय डूइंग. क्लियर? सो दिस इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन द ऑन द जॉब एंड ऑफ द जॉब द ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग. देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज नंबर टू, दैट इज हियर द पोजिशंस रोटेशंस. ओके, पोजिशंस रोटेशंस, वट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ पोजिशंस रोटेशन? द मेजर ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस जॉब रोटेशन इज दैट broadening of the background of the trainee in the organizations. This type of training involves the movement of the trainee from one job to another. The trainee receives job knowledge and gain experience from his supervisor or trainer in each of the different assignment. The method gives an opportunity to the trainer to understand the operational dynamics of a variety of job. There are certain disadvantages of this method is that the productive work can suffer because of the obvious disruptions caused by such changes. Rotations become less useful as specializations proceeds, for few people have breadth of the technical knowledge and skill to move from one functions to another. Good. Positions rotations means rotations, the rotational job. Take one example is here. Some people are expert as you are a student of politics, you all are students of political science. So there are many subjects are there in political science, like that of public administrations, like that of your human resource management, your theory of political science, international relations. Okay, so we are having the 8 and 9 your subjects are there. So some persons, all the persons are not expertise in every field. Okay, I may be expertise in public administration and Western thought, but I am not a expert in the field of international relations. So by which sometimes what happened, if I was assigned to teach your international relations for a period of 2 or 3 months, then what will happen? You think that I have improved myself? No. First of all, initially I have to prepare, then I have to develop, then I have to teach you. Okay, मुझे पहले पढ़ना है, फिर develop करना है, फिर आपको पढ़ाना है. तो ये जो job rotations policy होता है, ये इसलिए किसके लिए benefit होता है? वो newly जो enter करते हैं, जो नया नए young वाले जो होते हैं, उनके लिए आपको positions पर rotations of job अच्छा रहता है, क्योंकि इसमें एक advantages होता है. Suppose public administration वाला नहीं आया, तो जो international relations वाला होता है, वो आके उसका क्लासेस वो ले सकता है. सपोज वो आदमी ट्रांसफर हो गया, तो आप दोनों चैप्टर आप पढ़ा सकते हो. बाय व्हिच व्हाट हैपेंड, द ऑलराउंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल कैन बी हैपेंड, बट द थिंग द मेन डिमेरिट्स इज दैट द स्पेशलाइजेशंस कैन नॉट बी अचीव, बिकॉज इफ ए पर्सन इज टेकिंग ए क्लास ऑन ए बेसिक सब्जेक्ट, ऑन ए स्पेसिफिक सब्जेक्ट, देन ही कैन इंक्रीज हिज एक्सपर्टाइज ऑन दैट फील्ड. क्लियर? अगर आप कोई काम को, कोई क्लासेस हो या कोई प्रोसेस को एक टाइप की रिपीटेडली करते हो, तो उसमें क्या होता है, आपकी स्पेशलाइजेशन उस फील्ड में आपका बढ़ जाता है. मैं आपको बोलूंगी कुछ दिन के लिए आप प्रोडक्शन में बैठ जाओ, कुछ दिन के लिए आप मार्केटिंग में बैठ जाओ, कुछ दिन के लिए आप फाइनेंस में बैठ जाओ, आपकी रोटेशनल जॉब में कर दूंगी. नो डाउट यू आर गेनिंग द नॉलेज इन एवरी फील्ड. यू हैव सम नॉलेज इन वेट टू प्रोक्योर, हाउ व्हाट इज द इन्वेंट्री, हाउ टू प्रोक्योर, हाउ टू परचेज, व्होम टू सेल, देन व्हाट शुड बी द परसेंटेज ऑफ प्रॉफिट, सो एवरीथिंग. बट जैसे आपको बोलते हैं, क्या बोलते हैं, जैसे लिटिल नॉलेज जो होता है, छोटा छोटा जो बुद्धि होता है ना, वो काफी भयंकर होता है. ओके, सो द पर्सन कैन नॉट बी पोजेसिंग ए वर्सटाइल योर कैरेक्टर. ओके, द जस्ट लाइक इज द what expertise in every field, every your field is not the master of all tasks. Just like there is a saying is there, I was forget what was that, the person who is expertise in every field, the master of none. जिसको लगता है मैं सब कुछ जानता हूँ, वो किसी एक में मास्टर नहीं रहता है. सो पोजिशंस रोटेशंस वही होता है, जैसे आपने एक चीज में दूसरे चीज को रोटेट कर लिया, कुछ दिन के लिए आप इन्वेंटरी, कभी मार्केटिंग में, कभी प्रोडक्शन में. तो ये चीज होता है जो न्यू जनरेशन के लिए बेटर है, ऑलराउंड डेवलपमेंट के लिए. बट देर विल बी सम प्रॉब्लम इन द एक्सपर्टाइज ऑफ द नॉलेज और मे बी द स्पेशलाइजेशन ऑफ द नॉलेज. सो पोजिशंस रोटेशन इज दैट. ओके, देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड एज अ स्पेशल प्रोजेक्ट. सो वॉट इज मीनिंग हियर द स्पेशल प्रोजेक्ट? दिस इज ए फ्लेक्सी ट्रेंड So special project assignment grow ordinary out of an individual analysis of weakness. The trainee may be asked to perform special assignment, thereby he learns the work procedures. Trainer not only acquire knowledge about the assignment activity, but also learn how to work with other. Just like is the projects. Sometimes what happens, some projects are coming to you and you are working under your supervisor. Okay, so that is called as a special project. You have your supervisor got a project, and that project is upon what? On the rural development of some tribal peoples. Okay, so you are a the scholar, and you are doing your project under your guide. Then what will happen? Through the training, through the systems, what happened, you generally gain some knowledge from your trainer that you can develop the basic knowledge about who may be called rural development means what, who may be called as the backward people, who are coming under the backward people, what is the meaning of the rural people. So these things the supervisor can easily guide you through the type of the project, okay, that you are undergo. Then the next one is called as the selective readings. So this is also a training method. Selective readings means what? The individual in the organizations can gather and advance their knowledge and background through selective reading. The reading may be include professional journals and books, various business organizations maintains library for the staffs. Many executive becomes member of the professional association and they exchange their ideas with other. This is a good method of assimilate knowledge. However, some executive claims that it is very difficult to time to do much reading and then absolutely required in the performance of their job. Selective reading means what? Sometimes in company, so in some school, in some organizations, they have introduced some types of the journals, some types of the magazines that will help the employee in order to solve the problems. Like that of the business plans are there, like that of your Yojana. Magazines like that of the Yojana, by reading through the case study, by reading through the different concepts that how you can be comprehending some subjects or some problems, and an individual or a member can easily go through the training process. Take one example, I am telling you that in Odisha, what happened? I am not criticizing any publications, but the thing is that in Odisha, but number of students that giving that examination in Odia language, okay, the medium of language is Odia. So whenever I am asking them what the type of the book that you are taking, that what is the author of the book, so they told me that for Western theory they basically they follow your Kalyani publications, your Kitab Mahal. So these things are there. They are called a chatti books. Chatti books means what? That you are not getting any type of principles, the solid concepts in that from that type of the chatti books. Chatti books means that like called as the petty types of your works that just like notes. That is called a chatti books. Notes are there, platform notes are there. Okay, so you always like a student of political science, like the student of the public administration, your igno material is good, but beside igno material you can take the help of your BSP Rao, like that of your Ashwath Thapa, like that of your Keith Davis. So different books are there. So if you are taking this type of the help from selected readings are there, and if you are taking this type of selected readings, then you can be an easy performer or a good performer in an organization. का जॉब में आप अच्छे से परफॉर्मेंस कर सकते हो, तो इसमें होता है सिलेक्टिव रीडिंग्स. देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड एज अप्रेंटिसशिप, बिकॉज़ एवरीवन नो अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ अप्रेंटिसशिप. अप्रेंटिसशिप इन द ट्रेनिंग कैन बी ट्रेस्ड बैक टू मेडिएवल टाइम व्हेन दोज इंटेंडेड ऑफ लर्निंग ट्रेड स्किल्स बाउंड देमसेल्फ टू मास्टर क्राफ्ट एंड नथिंग एल्स. सो इन अप्रेंटिसशिप व्हाट हैपेंड, persons that after completion of his theoretical your study, he has to go on for a period of what, the training, and that is called as apprenticing. So here the training means what, a person is doing and getting some reward or some getting some monetary benefits for his job. Okay, so in the type of the apprenticeship, you are doing your apprenticeship in some company or in some organizations like that. Of if you are an HR employee or an HR your person, you if your specialization is HR human resource, then after completion of your theoretical aspect, then you have to join some hotel, some your what. Some companies where you can be indulged or you can be see on how to recruit, where to recruit, what is the procedures they will follow. So these things say that this is called as the apprenticeship, and they will pay you, the hotel manager will pay you some lucrative amounts like that of 20, 30, 40, whatever may be, depending upon the rating of the hotels, five-star hotels, two-star hotels. So these that they are giving you. Now, suppose take one example that you are in specialization in marketing or in some other field, like that a computer, some software company that you have to join, and your college or your institutions, they are sending you to undergo the apprenticeship, your training for a period of your 3 months. This is basically for a period of the 3 months. Then the next one is called as the vestibule training. So last, what do you mean by the vestibule training? The large organizations are frequently provided with what is described as vestibule school, a preliminary to actual shop experience. As far as possible, some conditions are duplicated under the close watch of this instructor. Vestibule schools are widely used in training for clerical and office job as well as for factory production job. So training is through shorter and less complex, but is relatively expensive. However, the costs are justified if the volume of training is large and high standard result. So vestibule schools or vestibule training is nothing, that it may be sometimes called as that. Suppose कभी आप market गए हो, आपका जो phone होता है ना, तो phone खरीदने आप market जाते हो, ठीक है ना? You want to purchase your phone, and whenever you ask for your phone, वो directly open करके आपको दिखा देता है phone कि आपको ये Vivo लेना है या आपको जो भी फोन लेना है, गैलेक्सी 21 लेना है या कुछ जो भी लेता है, वो आपको खोल के दिखाता है फोन को या नहीं दिखाता है, बताओ? ये डोमी दिखाता है, मैं आपको पूछ रही हूँ, बताओ? जब आप जाते हो, मार्केट जाते हो, तो मार्केट में जो फोन खरीदने जाते हो, तो फोन आपको वो जो फोन होता है वही फोन देता है या डोमी फोन देता है आपको, बताओ?
वही फोन देते हैं,
जो फोन खरीदते हैं वही देते थे आपको ओरिजिनल?
नो मैम, जब दिखाने के टाइम वो डोमी दिखाता है,
डोमी दिखाता है ना, तो परचेज के बाद तो वही देंगे, ऐसे थोड़ी है कि डोमी दे देंगे, लेकिन जब आप दिखाते हैं तो उसी टाइम क्या होता है, डोमी दिखाते हैं, ठीक है ना? नहीं, उसी टाइप की जब आप कोई कंपनी में ज्वाइन करना चाहते हो, तो उसी टाइप की आपका एक आर्टिफिशियल एक एनवायरमेंट क्रिएट होता है. So this is called as what? This is called as vestibule schools. So artificial आपका environment create होता है. So it is very costly. So इसमें क्या होता है? आप 15 दिन, 16 दिन या 10 दिन या 12 दिन तक आप काम करोगे. आपको ये procedures, जैसे आप air hostess में आप join कर रहे हो, तो उसमें आपको पता है तो कैसे आना है, कैसे जाना है, क्या करना है. तो एक type of environment आपका create banking job में. वेस्टिबल्स आपका ट्रेनिंग प्रोवाइड किया जाता है, एयर होस्टेस ट्रेनिंग में आपका जो जॉब होता है उसमें भी आपका वेस्टिबल्स ट्रेनिंग आपको प्रोवाइड किया जाता है. पुलिस जॉब में शायद देते हैं मुझे लग रहा है, तो क्योंकि आपको 1 month तक आना है. मैंने ये भी देखा है, जैसे आपका जो स्विंग करने जाते हो, जो सिलाई करने जाते हो, तो उसमें भी आपको मशीन को भी ये लोग 1 महीने चलाने देते हैं. तो ये होता है आपका वेस्टिबल स्कूल्स और वेस्टिबल ट्रेनिंग्स. इट मींस व्हाट? एन आर्टिफिशियल सराउंडिंग हैज बीन क्रिएटेड, ए डोमी और आर्टिफिशियल सराउंडिंग हैज बीन क्रिएटेड व्हिच इज सो कॉस्टली फॉर द योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, एंड द एम्प्लॉई वाज इंटरेस्टेड एंड गिव गेट एंड द एम्प्लॉई वाज ट्रेन्ड ऑन द टाइप ऑफ द एनवायरमेंट. द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस थिंग इज दैट इन ऑर्डर टू मिटिगेट हेवी लॉसेस, accidents or what the damage, etc. and etc. So this is called as the vestibule schools. Then the next point is coming. So how many types of training? Again, I am repeating here that on specific job, experience, coaching, understudy, positions, rotations, वन जॉब से दूसरा जॉब, दूसरा से तीसरा जॉब, पोजीशंस रोटेशंस, देन प्रोजेक्ट, यू ऑल नो व्हाट इज द प्रोजेक्ट, ए थीम आता है, एक काम आता है जो आप सुपरवाइजर के नीचे काम करोगे, सो यू हैव टू आस्क अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट दैट यू आर अंडरगोइंग योर प्रोजेक्ट, लाइक ट्राइबल, योर रूरल, सो दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट दैट आर कमिंग एंड यू आर डूइंग योर रिसर्च वर्क अंडर सम सुपरवाइजर. Then selective reading some journals, some magazines, some officials' books, some publications that are directed towards you, that that the officers or maybe your manager, he asked to you to go through this type of the book, you know, for the problem solving. So standard books are there, some standard journals are there. Then apprenticeship, after completions of your theoretical work, a person is gone for the increasing his skilled work, the person is undergo for what, the apprenticeship. The apprenticeship, you can did your apprenticeship in medicine, in craftsmanship, in marketing, in any type of industrial organization for a period of maximum period of 3 months, and for this part what happened, you get some benefit, some salary for your performance. Then vestibule schools means what, vestibule training means what, some dummy environment was created, some artificial things was created, and under those things that you have to did your work. So then the next point is coming here, that is called off the job training. Student, any doubt having, you are facing any doubt, then ask, otherwise I will go to off the job training. You are facing any doubt? Are you facing any doubt, Aditya? Aditya, are you facing any doubt? Then ask. You slept? आप सो गए क्या?
No ma'am.
तो कोई doubt है तो पूछो.
नहीं ma'am, doubt नहीं.
सब समझ में आ गया?
अच्छा मैं पैरालली एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का एक कॉल था तो वो लेता है, तो वही 40 मिनट का, तो मैं पहला भी ज्वाइन किया हूँ.
नहीं समझ में आया, दिखते फिर से रिपीट करो क्या बोल रहे हो.
मैं एक्चुअली पैरेलली दो ही मीटिंग में ज्वाइन किया हूँ, इससे हूँ और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का एक स्टैंड अप कॉल था, तो उसमें मतलब देख रहा था, मतलब आप जो पढ़ा रहे हैं टाइप्स ऑफ ये सब सेलिंग वगैरह, फोन का आपने एग्जांपल वगैरह दे रहे थे, तो मैं एक्चुअली क्लास पे हूँ, पर थोड़ा इधर.
अच्छा आदित्य, मुझे एक बात बताओ, फेस्टिवल ट्रेनिंग क्या होता है? आता है
फेस्टिवल,
फेस्टिवल ट्रेनिंग आपकी कंपनी का फेस्टिवल ट्रेनिंग दिया
है? जैसे कि एग्जांपल मैम, एक्चुअल में टर्मिनोलॉजी पहली बार सुन रहा हूं.
अच्छा, आप कौन सी जॉब, आप कौन सी कंपनी में बताए थे मुझे?
मैं आईटी पे हूं.
आईटी पे, तो आईटी में फेस्टिवल ट्रेनिंग दिया जाता नहीं है? जैसे डोमी टाइप का आपका एनवायरनमेंट क्रिएट होता है ऑफिस का, उसमें आप कुछ दिन के लिए परफॉर्मेंस करोगे, इसमें इसका मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ये होता है, आपका जो एक्सीडेंट डैमेज होता है या प्रोडक्टिविटी को कम, या आपका स्क्रैपिंग, ये सब कम करने के लिए फेस्टिवल ट्रेनिंग का आपका दिया जाता है. जैसे आपकी नर्सिंग में हुआ, आपका
उस तरह का हो सकता है, एक ईआरटी का होता है जो इमरजेंसी के लिए, जैसे कि कुछ फायर वगैरह लग रहा है या फिर कुछ हो रहा है, तो इसका इस तरह का एक ड्रिल होता है जिसमें मैम जैसे कि मतलब वो सिखाते हैं कि अगर फायर वगैरह या फिर अलार्म वगैरह बजा है तो आपको क्या करना चाहिए पहले, तो मतलब कैसे इमरजेंसी एग्जिट में आपको जाना चाहिए.
और मतलब आपका होता है इसका मतलब?
यस मैम, वो होता है.
हाँ, वेरी गुड. अब आपको समझ में आ गया सारे स्टूडेंट, वेस्टिबुल ट्रेनिंग समझ में आ गया ना?
यस मैम.
ओके, अब आगे जाऊं मैं दी जॉब ट्रेनिंग में. आदित्य थोड़ा म्यूट कर दीजिए. ओके, देन द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड एज दैट द ऑफ दी जॉब ट्रेनिंग मेथड. सो यू नो दैट ऑफ दी जॉब ट्रेनिंग मेथड का मतलब क्या होता है, ट्रेनिंग बाय लर्निंग, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज दैट द ऑफ दी जॉब ट्रेनिंग. सो इन दिस जॉब द ट्रेनी हैव टू लीव देयर वर्क प्लस एंड डिवोट देयर एंटायर टाइम टू द डेवलपमेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव. इन दिस मेथड वो काम पे नहीं रहता है, काम छोड़ता है कुछ दिन के लिए. इन दिस मेथड डेवलपमेंट ट्रेनिंग इज प्राइमरली एंड एनी यूजेबल वर्क प्रोड्यूस ड्यूरिंग द ट्रेनिंग is secondary. Since the trainee is not instructed by job requirement, he can place his entire concentration on learning the job rather than on spending his time in performing it. There is an opportunity for freedom of expressions of the trainee. Of the job training method are as follows. सो मेन चीज क्या होता है, ये जॉब से बाहर होके जब करता है तो उसको बोलते हैं ऑफ द जॉब ट्रेनिंग मेथड. सो ये ट्रेनिंग का मेथड प्राइमरीली को क्या होता है ना, स्पेसिफिक स्किल को गेन करने के लिए नहीं होता है. सो इंडिविजुअल्स का पर्सनालिटी, जॉब परफॉर्मेंस, जॉब के लिए ये चीज होता है. जैसे डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ट्रेनिंग इज प्राइमरीली एंड एनी यूजेबल वर्क प्रोड्यूस ड्यूरिंग द ट्रेनिंग. जस्ट लाइक आप सेमिनार अटेंड किया तो ऑफ द जॉब ट्रेनिंग हुआ, आप फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम किया, आप एमडीपी किया, मैनेजरियल डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम किया, ये सारे चीज आपका ऑफ द जॉब ट्रेनिंग मेथड होता है. तो उसमें क्या होता है, जो आपकी मैनेजरियल स्किल्स होता है वो बढ़ता है. तो दिस कमिंग अंडर द ऑफ द जॉब ट्रेनिंग मेथड. सिंस द ट्रेनी इज नॉट इंस्ट्रक्टेड बाय द जॉब रिक्वायरमेंट, ही कैन प्लेस हिज एंटायर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑन लर्निंग द जॉब बिकॉज एज इट हैज इंक्रीज्ड व्हाट the personality of an individual, the professional aspect of an individual. So he is not required to concentrate on the job, but he has to require to concentrate upon the training program. So this is called as the off-the-job training method. So there are the different types of your off-the-job training method. The first one is called a special course and lectures. Okay, so what is the meaning of special course and lecture? The lecturing is the most traditional forms of formal training method. Special course and lectures can be organized by organization in numerous ways as part of the development programs. First, there are courses which the organizations themselves established to be taught by members of the organization. Some organizations have regular instructor assigned to their training and development department. A second approach to special course and lecture is of organizations to work with university or institute in establishing a course or series of course to be taught by instructor of this institution. A third approach is of the organizations to send personnel to program organized by the university, institute and other bodies. Such courses are organized for a short period ranging from 2 to 3 days. Like that of special course and lectures. So take one example is that if you are in a medical field and some practical experience and practical knowledge is required on that particular academic aspect, then what will happen? Some good expertise or some good resource person was called on the particular field and they will take your class for a period of 1 to 2 days or maybe some one day also for 2 to 3 hours. And for this purposes, what happens? Some monetary reward has been given to them and that is called a special course and special lectures. Okay, so these are coming like that of the persons having like that of emirates. They are called as the persons emirates. So they are coming, the resource persons that are expertise on that particular field and they're giving you the lecture on that field. Also, this is called a special course and lectures. Then the next one is called as the conference. So all know the meaning of conference here. So this is an old but still a favorite training method. In order to escape the limitation of starting lectures, many organizations had adopted guided discussions type of conference in the training program. In this method, the participant pool their idea and experience in attempting to arrive at improved method of dealing with the problem. Clear? In a conference, what happened? A particular type of the topic has been selected and number of persons are there. Sometimes the professional, the resource and sometimes the expertise are invited and they will give their they will take their classes on that particular, on the specific field. Sometimes presentations was also given by the participants and the participants can easily ask the questions relating to the problems that they were facing inside the conference. So in the conference, the main objective of the conference is that whatever you are having, you are facing some problem or some doubts are there, then the resource persons are there, then they can easily solve your problems. This is called as the conference. And the conference is for a period of one and two or three day only, like that of inaugural, like that of validatory, and like that of technical session. So three sessions are there. So within the three sessions, in the technical session, the researcher or the participants they are presenting their papers, and depending upon their papers, the other participants, the observer, they can ask the questions, and this is all about the conference. Okay, different type of your certificates was distributed in the conferences. So this is a good things for every persons that who have attended conference. Okay, like that of your marketing conference, human resource for conference. So number of conferences was organized by Government of India and some private sectors. Then the next one is called as the case study. So what do you mean by case study? Any student try to say? Thak gayi main ekdam se. Case study kya hoti hai? Aap batao. Case study kya hoti hai? Case study. Kisi ko pata hai case study kya hoti hai? Agar koi research kiya ya aapka किसमें आप मार्केटिंग में हो या एचआर में हो तो केस स्टडी क्या होती है? ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग क्या होता है आपको पता है? ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग, डॉल्फी टेक्निक, ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग, केस स्टडी, कुछ पता है आपको मार्केटिंग में? चलो ठीक है. केस स्टडी क्या होता है? ये हार्वर्ड स्कूल ने केस स्टडी डेवलप किया है. केस स्टडी इज रिटन अकाउंट ऑफ ट्रेनी रिपोर्ट ऑन एनालिस्ट सीकिंग टू डिस्क्राइब इन एक्चुअल सिचुएशंस. केसेस आर वाइडली यूज्ड इन ए वैरायटी ऑफ प्रोग्राम्स. दिस मेथड इंक्रीजेस द ट्रेनर पावर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन, हेल्पिंग देम टू आस्क बेटर क्वेश्चंस एंड टू लुक फॉर ए ब्रॉड रेंज ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स. ए वेल चूजन केस में प्रमोट ऑब्जेक्टिव डिस्कशन बट ही लैक ऑफ इमोशनल. आई एम टेलिंग यू जस्ट लाइक in our medical, what happened, we are facing number of cases are there, like that of the person named X, he is suffering from cancer. Okay, so the expert is there who has to source the parallel type of the case in order to solving the problem. Okay, ek aadmi hai jo cancer mein affected hai, तो उसको सॉल्व करने के लिए हमें क्या करना है? उसी टाइप के एक दूसरा आदमी का केस हम स्टडी करते हैं, उसमें जो जो आप रेमेडीज दिए हो, जो जो आपने एप्लीकेशंस दिए हो, उस एप्लीकेशंस को आप इसमें लगाते हो. तो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द केस स्टडी. जैसे घर में क्या होता है, किसी का बच्चा पढ़ता नहीं है तो दूसरे को बच्चे का हम केस स्टडी लेके आते हैं. जैसे हम बोलते हैं वो पढ़ता नहीं था, बाद में पढ़ना शुरू कर दिया. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ऑल्सो द केस स्टडी. सो हियर इन एचआरएम ऑल्सो वी आर हैविंग ए नंबर ऑफ केस स्टडीज आर देयर, लाइक दैट ऑफ योर कोको कोला कंपनीज केस स्टडी, लाइक दैट ऑफ योर KFC केस स्टडी. सो हाउ इट हैज बीन, व्हाई, हाउ इट वाज डेवलप्ड ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ द डेवलपमेंट, what is the brand name of KFC, what is the full form of KFC, where it is originated. So everything we have to go through the case study. If a company is suffering the marketing or suffering any type of the marketing loss, then we have to search out the case study that is relating with that type of the case. So this is called as the case study. Case study is nothing but you have to find out or identify the same type of the problems that a company suffering. So this is called as case study. आपको उसी टाइप की केस ढूंढना है जो एक दूसरा कंपनी सफर करता है, तो इसको बोलते हैं केस स्टडी. देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड एज द ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग. यस, सो इन योर यूजीसी नेट द क्वेश्चंस विल कम अबाउट दैट व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग. सो ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग मींस व्हाट? ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग एंड डेल्फी टेक्निक, देयर आर नंबर ऑफ थिंग्स आर देयर इन एचआरएम. So what is the meaning of brainstorming? This is the method of stimulating training to creative thinking. This approach is developed by Alex Osborne, seeks to reduce inhibiting forces by providing for a maximum of group participant and a minimum of criticisms. A problem is posed and ideas are sought. Quantity rather than the quality is primarily objective. Ideas are encouraged and criticism of any idea is discussed. Chain reactions from idea to idea is often developed. Later than the idea are critically examined. There is no trainer in brainstorming. Brainstorming frankly favor this divergence, and this fact may be sufficient to explain why brainstorming is so little used. Okay, so brainstorming is nothing but it may be called as the group discussion. But in the group discussion, what happened? The main objective of the group discussion is that we are not trying to find out different idea in order to solving any type of problems. Okay, so group discussion, what happened? Only the discussion has been carried out. But in the brainstorming, what happened? A problem was generalized and we have to what try to find out or sort out different type of the idea or find out different type of the idea in order to sort out the problems. Okay, so from the different type of the idea, there are different type of idea, like X, A is giving some idea, B is giving some idea, C is giving some idea. So among the number of the idea, we are sorting some of the idea, that is called as brainstorm. Storm means what? Just like is the आपके जो 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 शरीर के अंदर जो हेड है ना, उस हेड में जो आपकी स्टॉर्म होता है, कोई भी चीज को आप बार 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 थिंकिंग थिंकिंग अगेन रीथिंकिंग, सो बाय थिंकिंग एंड थिंकिंग एनीथिंग एल्स दैट यू आर एट द एंड ऑफ द डे यू विल फॉर्म टू एन आइडिया एंड अमोंग द नंबर ऑफ द आइडिया यू आर सॉर्टिंग सम ऑफ द आइडिया एंड यू हैव टू क्रॉस एग्जामिन द आइडिया इफ यू विल अप्लाई दिस आइडिया इन माय प्रॉब्लम्स वेदर इट विल बी गेट बेनिफिट टू मी अदरवाइज नॉट. If it will get benefit to me, then you have to apply this idea. So this is called as the brainstorming. Brainstorm करना आपका जो हवा में brainstorm होता है तो उसी type के आपका stones करना है. Then the next one is called as the laboratory training. Brainstorming समझ में आया student? Brainstorming.
Yes ma'am.
आ गया ना? Okay. देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड एज द लेबोरेटरी ट्रेनिंग. लेबोरेटरी ट्रेनिंग का मतलब क्या होता है? लेबोरेटरी ट्रेनिंग एड्स टू कॉन्वेंशनल ट्रेनिंग बाय प्रोवाइडिंग सिचुएशंस विच द ट्रेनी देमसेल्फ एक्सपीरियंस थ्रू देयर ओन इंटरेक्शंस. इन दिस वे देयर मोर और लेस एक्सपेरिमेंट इन द कंडीशंस ऑफ देमसेल्फ. लेबोरेटरी ट्रेनिंग इज मोर कंसर्न अबाउट चेंजिंग इंडिविजुअल बिहेवियर एंड एटीट्यूड. इट इज जनरली मोर सक्सेसफुल इन चेंजिंग जॉब परफॉर्मेंस देन कॉन्वेंशनल ट्रेनिंग मेथड. देर आर two methods of laboratory, namely simulation and sensitive training. Okay, so laboratory training का मतलब क्या होता है? जैसे आपका एक जैसे आप science लोगों को training दिया जाता है laboratory के अंदर, तो उसमें क्या होता है? It is a type of conventional training by providing by the your demonstrator. Okay, the demonstrator is there who is creating some type of the situations and the trainee themselves through his own experience or through his own interactions get the training from the your demonstrator. So this type of the training can be divided into two types. One is called as a simulation and second one is the role playing. Clear? What do you mean by the simulations here? What the type of the laboratory training I was telling you, this is the science type of the laboratory training. But in the HRM what happened, the laboratory training can be divided into two types. One is called as the simulation and second one is called as the your role playing. So what do you mean by the simulation? Simulations means what? An increasingly popular technique of management development is simulation of performance. In this method, instead of taking participant into the field, there can be simulated in the training session itself. Simulation is the presentation of real situations of organizations in the training session. It covers situations of varying of complexity and roles of the participant. It creates a whole field organizations related participant through three role and ask them to deal with specific situations of a kind they encounter in real life. There are two common simulation method of training, just like is the role playing and second one is a business game. So simulations method mein kya hota hai, aapka ek artificial aapka problem create kiya jata hai and you are asked to perform the role of some manager or some organizer, some marketer, and they will ask you that how you can solve the problems that was faced by the organizations. So simulations mein kya hota hai, koi bhi organization ke andar bahut sare problems hoti hain, to problem ko us problem mein agar aap ek marketer ke hisab se role play karke aap wo problem ko kaise solve karoge, to ye cheez aapko pucha jata hai aur ye cheez aapko sikha jata hai. To simulations ka first hota hai aapka role playing. Jaise क्या होता है, जैसे आपको पता है कि मार्केटिंग में क्या होता है, प्रोडक्ट नहीं बिकते हैं, तो मार्केटिंग में क्या होता है आपका जो जो क्या बोलते हैं बात आपका बिकते हैं, मतलब द पर्संस purchasing not the product but the person's purchasing your behavior. If you want to sell the pen to then it will totally depends upon the type of the behavior and the type of attitude and the time the mind of a person that you can increase the percentage of profit from the 5 to 10 rupees. So totally jo आपका कोई भी चीज हुआ, सपोज वन एग्जाम्पल आई एम गिविंग यू, सपोज आप देखते हो जैसे क्या जैसे आप फेसबुक या आपकी कोई सोशल मीडिया में जाते हो, जब आपको एक प्रोडक्ट आता है, जैसे कोई आप इसको 3 बार लगा दो तो गोरा हो जाते हो, तो उसमें आपको पता है कि ये कभी होता नहीं है, लेकिन चीज क्या होता है, कभी आप हम लोग क्या करते हैं, पहले आप कमेंट ढूंढते, वो लिखता है आई एम फुल्ली सेटिस्फाइड विद द टाइप ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट दैट यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग, तो उस हमें लगता है कि वो काला आदमी गोरा बन गया। एक आता है दूसरा कि बाल 2 दिन में लंबा हो जाता है, तो ये जो चीज होती है ना, ये जो आपका जो रोल प्लेइंग जो होता है, इसमें क्या होता है दैट इट टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन द क्वालिटी ऑफ द सेलर, द मार्केट और द सेलर, दैट हाउ यू विल सेल द प्रोडक्ट। ओके, अगर आपका जो टैलेंट होता है वो टैलेंट में आपकी क्वालिटी खराब भी हो, लेकिन आपका टैलेंट अगर ठीक है तो कोई भी प्रोडक्ट हो, 5 रुपये के प्रोडक्ट हो, आपको 10 रुपये में बेच सकते हो। सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द रोल प्लेइंग। Okay, so before you are entering in or joining in any organizations, through this method, some period of the time, you will be a marketer, you will be a seller, sometimes you will be a production manager. So you will be playing your role depending upon the situations, on the actual realistic situations. So this is called as the role playing. Just like आपने बहुत बार टीवी में एक शो देखे हो, जैसे वो बोलता है कि आपको इसको 10 रुपये में बेचना है, वो कौन सा शो है मैं भूल गई, शार्क टैंक। ओके, तो शार्क टैंक जो देखते हो तो उसमें क्या होता है, आपका रोल प्लेइंग करते हैं, जैसे आप कोई भी चीज को आप 2 रुपये से आप 10 रुपये को बेचना है, तो आपके प्रोडक्ट उतना तक बिक सकते हो जितना तक आप दूसरों को बेवकूफ बना सकते हो। तो बेवकूफ होता है आपके प्रोडक्ट की क्वालिटी, आप कितने भी अच्छे चीज करो, लेकिन आप अगर कस्टमर को आप बेवकूफ नहीं बना सकते हो तो आपके प्रोडक्ट का सेलिंग नहीं हो सकती है। सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द रोल प्लेइंग। क्लियर? एनी डाउट स्टूडेंट? समझ में आया आपको रोल प्लेइंग क्या होता है? रोल प्लेइंग क्या होता है समझ में आया?
यस मैम।
अगर आप दरअसल आप देखो, आप सोशल मीडिया में आप इन्वॉल्व होते हो, ज्यादा से ज्यादा एडिक्ट होते हो, तो सोशल मीडिया में ज्यादातर लेडीज क्या देखते हैं, बाय वन गेट वन ऑफर, ओके 40% डिस्काउंट, ओके ब्यूटी प्रोडक्ट्स, ओके हेयर प्रोडक्ट्स। सो ये जो प्रोडक्ट्स होता है ना, ये प्रोडक्ट इजिली सेल हो जाती है, तो इसके लिए क्या करना पड़ता है, जो आपके जो कस्टमर है ना, आप जितने तक आप बेवकूफ बना सकते हो उतना तक आपके प्रोडक्ट आप सेल कर सकते हो। सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द रोल प्लेइंग। यू हैव टू प्ले द रोल ऑफ द मार्केटर इन सम सिचुएशंस, सम यू हैव टू प्ले द रोल ऑफ सम प्रोडक्शन मैनेजर इन सम सिचुएशन, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द रोल प्लेइंग। देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड एज द गेमिंग। ओके, सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ गेमिंग? गेमिंग हैज बीन डिवाइस्ड to simulate the problem of running a company or even a particular department. It has been used for a variety of training objects, from investment strategy, collective bargaining technique, to the moral or clerical personnel. It has been used at all levels, from the top executive to the production supervisor. Gaming is a laboratory method in which the role-playing exists, but its difference is that it forces attention on administrative problems, while role-playing tends to emphasis on mostly on interactions. Okay, so gaming involves several terms, teams, each of which is given a farm to operate for a specific period. Usually the period is a short one, say 1 or 2 say 1 year or so. In each period, each team make decisions on various matters such as fixation of price, level of productions, inventory level, and so forth. Since each team is competing with others, each farm decisions will affect the results of all others. All the farm decisions are fed into a computer which is programmed to behavior. So this basic difference between the gaming and or the role playing is that in the gaming, what happened, the emphasis is not upon the lower level of employee or the market or anything else, but here the gaming is totally focusing upon the administrative post. In the administrative post, what happened, that the number of problems has been arise, like that how to take the decisions, what should be the inventory is required, and how, where we have to send, where we have to procure the production, how you can increase your production. So these types of things that you can attend through the training process of the gaming method. Okay, जो gaming होता है वो आपके होता है, और द रोल प्लेइंग होता है वो द एंट्री लेवल्स के लिए, वो रोल प्लेइंग प्रोसीजर. सो दिस इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस. मतलब क्या होता है, एनी थिंग्स, एनी प्रॉब्लम्स, एनी पोस्ट दैट यू हैव टू मेक योर रोल और यू हैव टू प्ले योर रोल, एंड यू विल ट्राई थ्रू द रोल प्लेइंग. यू आर आस्क्ड to find out your the weakness and to find out the weakness and to emphasis upon your strength. But in the gaming process, what happened, the main objective of the gaming process is that it is totally emphasis upon the administrative management, that how they will take the decisions, where they have to procure the inventory, where they have to procure the finance. So these things are the big things are coming under here. So this is called as the gaming. Clear, student? Then the next one is called as sensitivity training. Any doubt, student? जब मैं पढ़ाती हूँ ना, मैं अकेला पढ़ाती हूँ तो मुझे अच्छा नहीं लगता. आप कुछ पार्टिसिपेट नहीं करते हो, कोई डाउट नहीं है आपके? चलो, मैं कंप्लीट होने के बाद मैं आपको क्वेश्चन पुट करूंगी, ऐसा ना हो सब सारे एग्जिट हो जाओ. शंकर नायक, you are always muting your audio. You don't have any doubt, Shankar? Shankar Naik, I'm asking you, only for attendance you are coming or you have some problems or doubt? Shankar Naik?
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Hmm? There is no doubt, ma'am, currently.
Kya kya, Shankar?
Nahi, ma'am, abhi koi doubt nahi hai. Doubt hoga to main aapko puch lunga.
अच्छा, आप जॉब में हो?
हाँ मैम, जॉब में.
तो जॉब में तो बहुत सारे डाउट आता है ट्रेनिंग के ऊपर में, आपका कोई डाउट नहीं है?
नहीं, अभी तक तो है नहीं. अब कुछ आएगा तब मैं दिमाग में, मैं आपको बताऊंगा.
बेफिकर होके आप दिमाग में बता सकते हो, क्योंकि आई एम नॉट योर कोच इन द ट्रेनिंग मेथड. आई एम नॉट योर कोच, बट हु एम आई? मैं किसके अंदर आऊंगी, आप बताओ. हाँ हाँ, बताओ. मैं आपको पढ़ा रही हूँ ना, ठीक है? आप जॉब में हो, आप तो मैं किस में आऊंगी, आप बताओ. एक्सपीरियंस में आऊंगी, कोचिंग में आऊंगी, ऑन द स्टडी में आऊंगी, किस में आऊंगे?
मैडम, आप तो एक्सपीरियंस में हो अभी.
वेरी गुड. तो कोचिंग में कौन आ सकता है?
कोचिंग में जब पढ़ा रहा होगा, जिसको नॉलेज थोड़ा ज्यादा कम होगा उसको.
कोचिंग में ये होता है, जो आपके जो इनसाइडर होते हैं ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के अंदर, जो इनसाइडर, जो आपके इमीडिएट बॉस होते हैं, जो वो कोच देते हैं, जिसके साथ आप फ्री नहीं हो, तो वो कोचिंग के अंदर आ सकते हैं. ठीक है? एक्सपीरियंस वाला आउटसाइडर होते हैं, कोचिंग वाला इनसाइडर होते हैं. क्लियर?
ठीक
है.
हाँ बताओ आदित्य.
हाँ, जो कोचिंग और मेंटरशिप जो है वो एक ही है या फिर अलग अलग है?
क्या क्या? कोचिंग और
मेंटरशिप.
मेंटरशिप, वेरी गुड क्वेश्चंस. आपकी जो मेंटरशिप होती है वो प्रोजेक्ट में आता है, असाइनमेंट में आता है. ओके. आपकी जो क्या कोई भी चीज में आपने जो प्रोजेक्ट किया है, और जो मैंने इधर लिखा हो स्पेशल प्रोजेक्ट, ओके, तो उसमें आपका आता है मेंटरशिप एंड आपका आता है सुपरवाइजर. दो चीज आता है. जो आदमी आपको ट्रेनिंग देते हैं वो सुपरवाइजर होते हैं या मेंटरशिप मेंटर होते हैं. और दूसरा क्या पूछा मैंने, आपने क्या पूछा?
कोचिंग
यही होता है, जो आदमी आपके आउटसाइडर होता है. लेकिन ये जो मेंटर होता है वो आपके इमीडिएट बॉस ही होते हैं. जो आपकी सुपरवाइजर या आपकी मेंटर, जैसे आप इग्नो में हो तो उसमें आपको पीएचडी करना है या आपकी कोई असाइनमेंट या प्रोजेक्ट करना है, तो जिसके अंडर में आप करोगे तो वो तो आपके इंस्टीट्यूट के अंदर से ही आते हैं ना. ठीक है? तो कोई स्पेसिफिक असाइनमेंट में है जिसके नीचे आप काम करते हो, तो वो होता है आपका मेंटर, आपकी सुपरवाइजर. ठीक है? जैसे आपकी 10-12 फैकल्टी है तो 10-12 सुपरवाइजर आपका बन गया. और दूसरा होता है आपका जो कोचर जो होता है वो आउटसाइडर होता है. एक्सपीरियंस वाला कोई भी हो जो आपकी प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करते हैं, जो एक्सपर्टाइज नॉलेज रखते हैं. तो ये तीन में जो डिफरेंस रहता है. ठीक है आदित्य?
यस.
और कोई डाउट नहीं है? आगे जाऊं?
यस मैम.
मुझे लग रहा है स्पीड तो नहीं हो रहा है आपको?
नहीं मैम.
क्योंकि आपके पास टाइम बहुत कम है, इसलिए मैं स्पीड कर रही हूँ। लास्ट वन है, आदित्य म्यूट कर दो। लास्ट वन है आपका सेंसिटिविटी ट्रेनिंग, यही पे थी मुझे लग रहा है। हाँ, सेंसिटिविटी ट्रेनिंग, इट इज द मोस्ट कॉन्ट्रोवर्सियल लेबोरेटरी ट्रेनिंग मेथड। मेनी ऑफ इट्स एडवोकेट्स हैव एन ऑलमोस्ट रिलीजियस जील इन द एनहांसमेंट विद द ट्रेनिंग ग्रुप एक्सपीरियंस। सम ऑफ इट्स क्रिटिक्स मेस दिस फेवर forever in their attacks on the techniques as a result of criticism and experience. A somewhat revised approach often described the as team development training has appeared. It was first used by Nason Training Laboratory at Bethel, USA. The training groups are called T group or sensitivity training. It is a small group interaction under stress in an understructured encounter group which require people to become sensitive to one another feeling in other in order to develop reasonable group activity. T group has several characteristics feature. Like T group is generally small, from 10 to 20 members. The group begins its activity with no formal agenda. The role of trainer is primarily to call attention from time to time ongoing process within the group. The procedure tends to develop introspections and self-examinations with emotional level of involvement. The objective of such training are concern for others, increase tolerance for individual difference, less ethic prejudice, understanding of a group process, enhanced listening skill, increased trust and support. Clear? तो सेंसिटिविटी ट्रेनिंग का मतलब क्या होता है? दिस इज कॉल्ड सेंसिटिविटी और टी ग्रुप टाइप ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग। सो इन दिस टाइप ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग द मेंबर्स आर आइडियोलॉजिकली दे हैविंग देर इज नो सिमिलरिटी इन देयर आइडियोलॉजी, बट बेसिकली दे आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम वन टू अनदर। So in this type of the training, what happened? The reactions of the participant or the members are highly welcomed or highly accepted relating to a particular problem or relating to the particular issues. Okay, so in this type of the training, sometimes what happened, it is an ongoing process. So in this type of the training, what happened, like that of some problems are there. Take one example I am giving you. There is a loss in the sale, आपका कोई प्रोडक्ट में लॉस हो रहा है, तो उसमें क्या होता है, 10 लोगों का आप बिठा दोगे तो उसमें आपको कोई किसी को नहीं जानता है, तो उसमें क्या करेंगे, एक दूसरे के ऊपर वो क्रिटिसिज्म होना शुरू होता है कर देगा। तो वो बोलेगा क्वालिटी में कम हुआ इसीलिए लॉस हो गया, वो बोलेगा वो जो आपका जो जहाँ पे आप वो प्रोडक्ट आपने सेल किया उसमें वो डिमांड नहीं था इसीलिए लॉस हुआ, तीसरा बोलेगा उसकी सीजन में अकॉर्डिंगली आपका लॉस हुआ, आप कॉटन के कपड़े आप विंटर में सेल किया इसीलिए आपका लॉस हुआ, फोर्थ बोलेगा कि मैन्युफैक्चरिंग डेट ज्यादा हो मतलब एक्सपायरी डेट के आसपास आ गया था इसीलिए वो लॉस हो गया। तो उसमें क्या होता है, आपका 5 और 6 प्रॉब्लम्स आप इजीली आप फाइंड आउट कर सकते हो। तो ये होता है क्या, ये टाइप ऑफ द ग्रुप व्हिच इज स्मॉल बट द मेंबर्स आर द आइडियोलॉजिकली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम वन टू अनदर, दे आर क्वाइट इंटेलिजेंट बट एंड दे आर ट्राइड टू व्हाट the putting stone from one to another, and by this idea what happened, you can easily catch some stone from this idea and you can easily come to the conclusion. आप इसमें से बहुत सारी चीज में जो प्रॉब्लम होती है तो बहुत सारी चीज को आप फिल्टर करके फाइनल सॉल्यूशन में जब आते हो तो दैट इज कॉल्ड सेंसिटिविटी ट्रेनिंग। कोई भी प्रॉब्लम दिया 10-12 लोग बैठ जाएंगे, ये वो ये इसके ऊपर उसके ऊपर सारे के सारे बताएंगे, तो इसके ऊपर जो फाइनल सॉल्यूशन आता है तो उसमें आप क्या करोगे, वो ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस के अंदर जब अप्लाई करते हो दैट इज कॉल्ड सेंसिटिविटी ट्रेनिंग, टी ग्रुप ट्रेनिंग और मे बी कॉल्ड दैट सेंसिटिविटी ट्रेनिंग। ओके, so here these are called as tensions group, these are the peoples are called as the tensions group, and ideological dissimilarity and the thing is that the persons that are attending the sensitivity training, the main objective of the persons that are attending the sensitivity training is that they want to give some idea to the organizations, and the trainer try to filter some of the idea from the generic idea and they try to apply this idea to the inside the organization. So this is called a sensitivity training. Then नेक्स्ट कम अंडर द कॉजेस ऑफ फेलियर ऑफ ट्रेनिंग. ट्रेनिंग क्यों फेल होता है? बिकॉज टॉप मैनेजमेंट डज नॉट हैव कंप्लीट फेथ बेसिकली इन एचआरडी फिलोसॉफी एंड हैज लिटिल कॉन्फिडेंस इन ट्रेनिंग इज एन इम्पोर्टेंट मेथड फॉर इंश्योरिंग डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फाइनेंशियल अगर आप नहीं दोगे तो ट्रेनिंग फेल होता है. दूसरा चीज मैं आपको सीधी बात कर बताती हूँ. पहले होता है आपका क्या होता है आपका मॉनिटरी प्रॉब्लम्स. दूसरा होता है लैक ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेशंस. तीसरा होता है प्रॉपर नॉट प्रॉपर एंड डिसअरेंजमेंट ऑफ टेक्निक्स और डिसअरेंजमेंट ऑफ इनपुट्स लाइक दैट ऑफ ट्रेनिंग में जो जो चीज जरूरत होती है वो आपको नहीं मिलना है नहीं मिल रहा है तो उसमें क्या होता है आपका ट्रेनिंग नहीं हो सकता है. चौथा चीज होता है व्हाट फाइंडिंग आउट ए गुड ट्रेनर. आपको ट्रेनिंग ट्रेनर अच्छा सा नहीं मिला तो आपका ट्रेनिंग नहीं हुआ. पांच नंबर होता है क्या आपका अगर किस पर्पोज में आपको ट्रेनिंग देना है. यू आर नॉट क्लियर अबाउट द ऑब्जेक्टिव अबाउट द पर्पोज ऑन व्हिच यू द ट्रेनिंग हैज बीन इम्पार्टेड देन ट्रेनिंग इज टोटली ए डिफेक्टिव प्रोसेस. सो मेनी थिंग्स आर देयर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड शुड बी वेलकम फ्रॉम द टॉप मैनेजमेंट साइड. द सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट यू द एचआर कौन है ओके. सो दीज आर द नंबर ऑफ योर डिफेक्ट्स ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग मेथड्स. नाउ इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ट्रेनिंग. इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ट्रेनिंग में क्या होता है ट्रेनिंग इवैल्यूएशन है. इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ कॉन्टेक्चुअल फैक्टर. इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ट्रेनिंग इनपुट्स. इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ट्रेनिंग प्रोसेस. इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ट्रेनिंग आउटकम्स. बिकॉज क्या होता है ट्रेनिंग किसके ऊपर डिपेंड करता है कॉन्टेक्चुअल फैक्टर्स के ऊपर. जिस जहाँ पे आपका ट्रेनिंग होता है वो सारा फैक्टर्स के ऊपर आपका ट्रेनिंग डिपेंड करता है. इनपुट्स के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है. प्रोसेस के ऊपर डिपेंड करते हैं. नाउ चार चीज इतना इसको एनालाइज करने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. देन इन एवेल्युएशन ऑफ आउटकम्स ट्रेनिंग आपका सक्सेसफुल हुआ या नहीं हुआ चार चीज के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है. पहला चीज होता है रिएक्शन. अगर आपका ट्रेनर का रिएक्शन पॉजिटिव है तो ठीक है. लर्निंग हाउ मच दे हैव लर्नड दैट इज ऑल्सो डिपेंड. चेंज ऑफ बिहेवियर. आपको जो इनिशियली जो एम्प्लॉय आपका इनपुट जो एंट्री किए थे जब ट्रेनिंग लिए हैं इसके बाद उसका बिहेवियर कैसे चेंज हुआ एंड व्हाट शुड बी द रिजल्ट. सो फोर प्रिंसिपल्स आर देयर और फोर मेथड्स आर दैट आर कमिंग. देन द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग इवैल्यूएशंस. इफ इवैल्यूएशन इन एनी फॉर्म इज टू बी इफेक्टिव इट मस्ट बी डन इन अकॉर्डिंग टू द फॉलोइंग प्रिंसिपल. दीज आर ट्रेनिंग इवैल्यूएशंस. सो आपको कैसे ट्रेनिंग को इवैल्यूएशन करना है ट्रेनिंग ठीक जा रहा है या नहीं जा रहा है. पहला चीज होता है इफ द ट्रेनिंग इज नॉट प्लान देन योर इवैल्यूएशन इज टोटली यू आर गोइंग थ्रू द रॉन्ग इवैल्यूएशन. सेकेंड वन इज दैट द ऑब्जेक्टिव शुड बी व्हाट दैट देयर शुड बी ए पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्टिव इन द ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम. थर्ड वन इज द ट्रेनिंग शुड बी वेरीफिएबल. फोर्थ वन इज दैट द पर्सन शुड बी कोऑपरेटिव. सो दीज ऑल थिंग्स अंडर कमिंग अंडर द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग इवैल्यूएशन एंड दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द कंक्लूजन्स. क्लियर. Here is that you have to only write down only the first of all what is the meaning of training. Training first मैंने आपको क्या बताया training क्या होता है जो आपकी which will encouraging your ability your knowledge your experience your thinking your interpersonal skill. So these are coming under the training. So these are all coming under the training. आपको ट्रेनिंग जरूरी है या नहीं जरूरी है कैसे पता चलेगा. बिकॉज यू हैव टू मिनिमा यू हैव टू सब्सट्रैक्टेड योर एक्चुअल परफॉर्मेंस फ्रॉम द स्टैंडर्ड परफॉर्मेंस. इफ योर एक्चुअल परफॉर्मेंस इज लेस देन योर स्टैंडर्ड परफॉर्मेंस देन यू आर रिक्वायरिंग योर ट्रेनिंग. सपोज आप कॉलेज में हो तो कॉलेज में दूसरों से आप जाकर कंपेयर करोगे तो आप पढ़ा नहीं पाते हो तो इसका मतलब यू रिक्वायर ए ट्रेनिंग थिंग ट्रेनिंग प्रोसीजर्स और ट्रेनिंग मेथड्स. देन देयर आर डिफरेंट इनपुट्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग. आपका क्या क्या इनपुट्स आपका जरूरत है ट्रेनिंग के लिए ये भी आपका इम्पोर्टेंट है. okay, through the training process, one person can increase his motor skill, psychomotor skill. Psychomotor skill का मतलब क्या होता है? That a person can easily understand how to operate a janitor to the general manager. आपका janitor क्या होता है? जो आपकी सफाई वाला से शुरू होके आपकी general manager के manager तक आपका जो भी psychomotor skill होता है, वो through the training method से आपका क्या होता है? Improve होता है. ओके सपोज एक जनरेटर आपको ही डिडंट नो हाउ टू यूज द मोप सो थ्रू द ट्रेनिंग प्रोसेस दे कैन ही कैन इजीली अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोसेस ऑफ यूजिंग द मोप सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द ट्रेनिंग मेथड देन थ्रू द ट्रेनिंग मेथड यू हैव टू इंप्रूव योर इंटरपर्सनल स्किल इंटरपर्सनल स्किल का मतलब क्या होता है जैसे द पेशेंस ऑफ लिसनिंग समटाइम्स यू शुड हैव दैट मच ऑफ पेशेंस टू लिसन योर सबॉर्डिनेट दैट आर वर्किंग अंडर यू the second thing is that you should have enough skill to persuade an individual who will demotivate to do the work. आपके नीचे जो काम करते हैं आपको काम करने की इच्छा नहीं है तो through the training program आप इसको motivate कर सकते हो pursue कर सकते हो and third thing is that showing an understanding in other feeling. You should have sympathy, some emotional sympathy towards the other persons in the training process. So these are all about the training and you only write down the difference between training and development, training, training, importance of training, then types of training and methods. And this all about your training. Okay, student, having any doubt? Do you have any doubt? Otherwise, I will skip. I will exit. In your next class, I will jump to unit number 11 and 12. Tomorrow, I will take 11 and 12. Okay, don't have any doubt. Okay, all the best and good night to all of you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Good night, ma'am.
Good night, okay. Ma'am.
Good night.